We're on problem 21. Which product is equivalent to 4x squared minus 16 over 2 minus x? So let's see if we can simplify this a little bit. 4x squared minus 16, if we were to factor out a 4, that's the same thing as 4 times x squared minus 4, right? That's 4x squared minus 16, all of that over 2 minus x. And then x squared minus 4, that's that same pattern that keep showing up, a squared minus b squared, right? So that numerator becomes 4 times x plus 2 times x minus 2, right? A plus b times a minus b. And then the denominator, let's think about it. This has 2 minus x, and we have an x minus 2 here. But what if we were to factor out a negative 1 from this? What happens? If you factor out a negative 1, then the negative x becomes a positive x, and then the positive 2 becomes a minus 2. And I did that just to show you that a negative, if you divide this by or multiply by a negative 1, you just switch the order. 2 minus x becomes x minus 2, which is a good thing to recognize because we have an x minus 2 in the numerator too. So this will cancel out with that. If we assume that x cannot equal, that x does not ever equal 2, because x equaling 2 would make this an undefined statement because you can't divide by 0. But if we make that assumption, we can cancel those out. And then we have 4 divided by negative 1 is minus 4 times x plus 2. And that is choice D. Choice D. Next question, 22. I like this cutting and pasting of the actual question. It makes it fun. So they want us to, I don't want it to slow down my computer too much. I sound like I'm melting when that happens. So that's our problem. I didn't write the choices down. All right, let's see what we can do. So they have x squared plus 4x times, let me write this. So x squared plus 4x over x plus 3 times x squared minus 9, all of that over x squared plus x minus 12, and you might say, oh my god, to multiply these using algebraic multiplication would take forever, and then I have to factor it and simplify it. And the trick here is to factor it and simplify it before you do any multiplication. So let's simplify each of these expressions and cancel out as much as possible. So here, we could just factor out an x. So this just becomes x times x plus 4, right? This is a squared minus b squared, so this becomes x plus 3 times x minus 3. That you can't do much. Now let's think about this one. What two numbers add up to a 1, right? A 1x. And when you multiply them, you get a minus 12. So let's see. If you got a x plus 4 times x minus 3, that should work. 4 minus 3 is 1. 4 times minus 3 is minus 12. So that works. All right, now we're ready to cancel. And you could view this. So this, normally I would just start canceling, but I just want to make the point home that this, so this is equal to x times x plus 4 times these, x plus 3 times x minus 3, all of that over x plus 3, x plus 3 times x plus 4, times x minus 3, right? And now we can cancel. We have an x minus 3, x minus 3, x plus 4, x plus 4, x plus 3, x plus 3, and all we're left is with an x. So all of this fancy expression, all that equals is an x. And that's choice B. Whatever, next problem. Image, clear image, invert colors, there you go. All right, let me see if I have to copy and paste this one. Where was I? Oh, why not? Another one where they're trying to get the simplest form. So I copied it. Go back to my, let me paste it. All right, hope you can read this. So what is the simplest form of this expression here? I'll rewrite it. 5x to the third y plus 20x squared y squared plus 20xy to the third, everything divided by 5xy. So 5xy actually goes into every one of these terms, right? So let's just get rid of the fives. If we divide the numerator and the denominator, well, actually, let's just divide the numerator and denominator by 5xy. So what's 5x to the third y divided by 5xy? Well, 5 divided by 5, I'll do it in magenta. 5 divided by 5 is 1, so we don't have to write that. X to the third divided by x is x squared. Y divided by y is 1. So this term divided by this term reduces to that. Easy enough. Next one. Plus, 20 divided by 5 is 4. X squared divided by x is x. Y squared divided by y is y. Did the second term. Let's do the third term. 20 divided by 5 is 4. X divided by x is 1. Y, we don't have to write it. Y the third divided by y is y squared. Y squared. And what we have here is this simplified, but that doesn't look like anything here. So my guess is that this is probably one of these. This is the square of something. And let's see if we could factor this. This would be x. So what two numbers, when I add them, become 4xy, and when I multiply them, or what number, when I multiply it times x, is equal to half of this, right? That's another way to think about it. And when I square it, is equal to 4y squared. Well, that's just plus 2y squared. And if that didn't make a lot of sense, multiply this out, and you'll get this answer. And when you look at the choices, you should just say, okay, I know that this choice and this choice, I mean, that those look nothing like that. And then you say, oh, well, maybe this is one of these choices, right? But you have a 4y squared here. This one has no y at all in it. So you could even just use deductive reasoning to say, oh, the choice must be x plus 2y squared. Next problem. Okay, this one I'm definitely going to copy and paste. Because they have a big image. All right, let me see if I can do it. This makes it a lot easier than having to draw it myself. All right. If I equals the square root of negative 1, which, well, if you didn't know it, that's what I is defined as, and I go on many videos about the magic of I and E and pi. Which point shows the location of 5 minus 2i on the plane? So this is the real. The x-axis is the real axis, so you take the real part, which is 5. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so that's the real part. And then the y-axis is the imaginary axis. So you take the imaginary part, minus 2i, minus 2, right? So you go down 2 in the I direction, and you're at point D, which is choice D. Fair enough. That problem had a lot of graphics, but was unusually simple. Next problem. Next problem. OK, now they're giving us a whole parade of imaginary number questions. So this one I don't have to copy and paste. They say if I is equal to the square root of negative 1, which is a definition that we've all learned, what is the value of I to the fourth? Well, let's just go back from, you know, let's say you've never seen I before in your life. And let's think about it. If I is equal to negative 1, sorry, this is negative 1. I know that negative looks like it got messed up. Let's square both sides of this equation. I squared will be equal to negative 1. Now let's square both sides of this equation, right? I squared squared is equal to negative 1 squared. Well, I squared squared is just I to the fourth, right? 2 times 2 is equal to negative 1 squared, which is just equal to 1. And we're done. That's choice C. All right, now they have another imaginary graph. So let me just copy and paste this graph. I'll go here. There you go. I just didn't have to erase what I had before. And the question they ask us, which of the following complex numbers is represented by the point on the graph below? So we just have to figure out the real and the imaginary parts. So what's the real part? This coordinate, its real part is 3. So its real part is 3. And its imaginary part is minus 4, right there. Minus 4. So it's 3, and its imaginary part, minus 4, in the imaginary direction. And we're done. 3 minus 4i. That's choice C. Choice C. And then I'm almost out of time. I'll see you.